What the Actual Fork podcast is co-hosted by two intuitive eating registered dietitians, yours truly, Sammy Previtt, owner of Fine Food Freedom, and Jenna Warner, owner of Happy Strong Healthy. We can't stand diet culture bullshit and love keeping it real. Our mission is for all humans to believe that they are made for so much more than chasing a smaller body. We are also here to share with you that food can be fun and pleasurable again. Although we are medical professionals, we are human too. We are not afraid to share our deepest, darkest secrets and how years of our lives were taken by diet culture. We started this podcast so no human has to feel alone in their journey towards food freedom. So get comfy and join us for a casual convo where you can expect to laugh, cry, learn, and grow.
Welcome back to another episode of What the Actual Fork podcast. We are just hoping that our audio works today. You never know with podcasting where we're at.
Because we are not professional podcasters.
We are professional podcasters. We're not having imposter syndrome today.
You're right.
But we are super excited because this episode, well, we're recording it like 2 days before we're releasing it, which never happens.
I know.
Which is awesome. So there's so much going on in the world. It's also National Registered Dietitian Day as we record
RD
this.
Day.
I know. And oh, how the responsibilities have changed in our roles over the years.
That's crazy. I'm going to be honest. I almost like didn't want to talk about RD Day at all on my socials today because it is created by the Academy of Nutrition and Dietetics, and I just don't feel like supporting them this year. But it is really important and special for us to be able to just look back at everything that we've done in our careers and how it brought us to this space.
Well, exactly.
Happy RD Day to you.
Thank you. Same to you. And I think I totally agree with you, and I couldn't agree more, especially with what's going on with the fucking new guidelines that the Academy put out. But I think it's important, like there are dietitians like you and like me and so many of our colleagues in this anti-diet space that like hopefully will continue to pave the way for future dietitians and change our field, because our field needs a lot of changing.
So much. And I think as we're talking about this, I think it's important to tell RDs to be that if you are in the space and feeling frustrated by maybe your coursework and education and, you know, the things that you're seeing, just know there are alternative paths once you get that RD credential, and we are here to help.
Yes. I know we always talk about like, I almost feel lucky that like we didn't know that we were harming people when we were going through school and how fucking disordered we were, because I can't imagine how hard it is to go through the dietetic course load right now, like understanding haze and intuitive eating. We didn't even know what those words were when we went
through. I got the weight management certification, heavy air quotes, back in like 2012 or whatever it was, because that was what they were pushing. Like, it is insane. And to me, knowing now that intuitive eating is like 27 or 28 years old, I think at this point, is that right?
I'm terrible at math.
I think it's within that range. The fact that, you know, I don't even remember it being brought up in school says so much. So we are holding space for all the RDs to be that know better and are trying to do better while navigating school. And super grateful to have more people that are coming into this field.
Yes. And we have a few different episodes that can support you if you're an RD to be. Just thinking about, we have a few, one that's going to be recorded soon with our dietetic students that help out with the pod, but also we have one that, what was it? It was something called RD to be. I should pull up our page here with Chelsea and Anna, the first one.
Yes.
And then we also
Jenny Westerkamp.
Yes, Jenny Westerkamp. We also have the one with Kimmy Singh, which she went into so much detail about how to get support like outside of your professors and classmates and whatnot, if you're going through didactic programming. So there's a bunch of different episodes, but this is the last one of season two.
Can you believe it?
No.
Me neither. No.
like so crazy. So like I need to pull up our episodes like in front of my face to look at
and I'm looking
what was the first one of season two. Like, where did this all start? I think it was August 6th. Yeah. Mm-hmm. We hit off season two, or we started with the medical care without weight stigma with Dr. Natasha Larmy, who is now known as Asher Larmy, who I guess we can
get a little
hint that Asher will be back for season three, which we're freaking excited about.
Oh, that episode was so good. Like so good.
Oh, so good.
Yeah. Season two has, I believe it's 30 or more episodes. And I feel like in this season, we went over a lot with children. There's a lot, and we continue to get a lot of questions through our Instagram channels about feeding kids and picky eating, quote unquote, and raising kids in this diet culture space. And there are a lot of episodes, I see at least three or four, where we do touch on that in this season, which if you guys are looking for something to go back to, there's lots of goodness in here. And not to mention, we also had Christy Harrison in season two.
Yes, we did. And at the end, she like threw out that she was pregnant and we like had no idea. And
I
was,
oh my goodness. She's got to be due soon.
Probably, or maybe even had her baby already. I have no idea. We'd have to go back and look, but I see on August 20th of 2021, that was the episode I was just referring to, how to address, be curious, and work through fat phobia with Kimmy Singh. So if you are a dietetic student, definitely recommend going through and listening to that. If you feel like you're struggling going through your coursework and like no one understands Haze and intuitive eating, and you feel like you're just being taught diet culture and fat phobia, Kimmy broke down so many good things in that episode. But yeah, so we have so many to touch on. Is there any one that's, I feel like we've asked this question before in our previous wrap-ups, but it's so hard. Like, is there any one episode that stuck out to you, or,
you know, I
mean, as you're scrolling through season two?
And some of my favorites from an educational standpoint, I love Dr. Heather Finley's episode about digestion, and also congrats to her. She just had a baby. I'm looking at this list. There are so many new babies from people that we interviewed, which is so amazing. Congratulations to everyone. But that episode I think was like so educational and in an area that is not talked about enough, but should be, because it's so pertinent to our health, which is your poop. So I think that one had such good information in it. I also absolutely loved, because it was so close to my heart, but the episode with Dr. Marta Perez talking about just postpartum depression and anxiety and all of the things that come with postpartum. That was a tough one for me, but like so needed, and I think will help so many people. And then of course, Caroline Dooner, like what a doozy and an amazing episode that was. That was last week, but that was a great way to kind of end this season as well. But what about you?
Yeah, that one definitely like felt like a therapy session. I feel like, even though Caroline is not a therapist, like it felt like she took us to therapy. I think looking at all of this, I definitely, one that stood out to me was on January 7th. Unfortunately, you couldn't be on that pod, but the one with Tiffany.
It's a good one.
Yeah, where she really broke down the difference between what is body image work and what is fat liberation, which I think gets really misconstrued on social media. And people think that those are the same things. And she kind of talked about like the body positivity movement and where it came from and how, again, freaking how much misinformation's out there on social. So that one really stuck out to me. And then I feel like obviously there's been big changes in my life personally throughout too. So I think like selfishly, I like used this podcast as a outlet to kind of share my story and emotions of going through my fertility journey. So I have that episode.
Not selfishly. You've helped thousands. I was going to say millions one day, millions of people going through it as well. So not selfishly. We are grateful for you.
Thank you for
sharing.
Thank you for saying that. But I guess, I mean, like it's just as it helps other people. And I've been so like, that's why I shared my journey, is because I I felt really alone. And so knowing that I could share it to help other people, it's been so, like, I feel selfish because every time I get a DM from someone and they're like, oh my gosh, this helped me so much. Like, I feel like it helps me knowing I'm helping other people, kind of thing.
Because you're a giver.
I was going to say that's because I'm a freaking people pleaser and still need to work through some of that. But between that one and then the one that we did with Nicola over at Fat Positive Fertility on Instagram, just our interview with her being able to shed light on fat phobia and weight stigma that is so prevalent in the fertility space. That was like, I feel like I literally send that podcast to somebody every single day, like whether it's a DM or a text message or anything, like, I feel like I just am always sending that one out. But again, like you and I always say, like every time I'm looking at these,
they're so good. Mimi Cole's episode. Remember that one? When you and I were like feverishly taking notes like the whole time.
Yeah.
It's also so funny looking back at these dates. So obviously when they're released, it's not when they were recorded. And so many of these were recorded when you and I were just going through so many personal changes in our own lives. Mm-hmm. And I'm sure you can hear that in our voices, like in some of these episodes too. So this is like a journal for us going back. It's pretty special. So thank you guys all for being part of our journal over the past two years now.
I guess, right? Because I feel like we started in COVID.
2020. Yeah, you're right. But we were recording before that. So you and I have been recording maybe close to 3 years, which is so crazy and amazing. And, you know, now that we're chatting about this, when we go on our little hiatus in between seasons here, Sam and I will be recording some incredible episodes for season 3. And we have plans to re-release some of our top 10 episodes. Is that top 10 episodes from of all time? I always say of all times, and my husband's like, what's times? I'm like, I don't know what this is.
I didn't even know that there was like a correct way to say that. So don't worry about it.
Of all time, our top 10 episodes, our most requested or downloaded episodes, will be reshared on our social platforms and on your listening services. So we'll keep you guys engaged, but we have some really incredible things coming up. And when we were talking about this, we were joking that Sam will be recording up until almost baby time. And that I remember... The last episode I recorded before Noah was born was, I think it was recorded at 4 p.m. And at noon that day, I started like leaking and I thought my water broke. And I remember call, and it was a huge interview and you couldn't be on it. And so I needed to be there. It was a big one with the body love girls.
Body Love Society.
Yes. And I remember I called my doctor at like noon and I was like, so, you know, I feel like I'm peeing my pants, but I'm not really sure like what's going on. It's not like a gush like you see on TV. It's just whatever. And I called my doula, I'm sorry. And she said, you know, what's the rest of your day look like? I was like, I have a really big interview at 4 o'clock and this wait until 5:30.
Please no, you could have canceled. Like, we need to go back to that, like, boundaries.
Long story short was like, you know, totally fine unless it gets worse. Like, keep me posted. So I called my doctor at that point and they were like, you at 5:30, I called the doctor and they were like, you need to come in. And I live 45 minutes from the doctor's office. I swore this was a Tuesday. I swore this was it. And they sent me home at like midnight that night, no baby. And then I had one day in between, like one day of doing quote unquote nothing because I was done working. And then Thursday I started having contractions and Sunday Noah was here. So
and when was your due date with Noah? Was that like right before the due date or that was weeks before?
It was a week. So it was weird because my period was so irregular. I actually had two due dates. So the first due date was January 18th. And then when they did my first scan, they said, no, we're going to change this to the January 23rd. We think you're a week behind. And I was like, okay. So it was 1 week apart. And if they were right the first time. He was born a day before his due date. But really, he was born at 39 weeks. Exactly. 39 weeks in one day, because my days were Saturday. So yeah, it was pretty funny. So this podcast sent me into labor, and we're not going to let that happen to Sam in the off season.
Yes, hopefully not. You never know. Well, yeah, because they say that to make it like a range, right? So it's like 2 weeks before your due date, 2 weeks after your due date. Yeah. And then with IVF, because they knew like the exact age of the embryo when they implanted it, like who knows if that even means your due date's more accurate or not, because I feel like due dates, they're like, it's like baby's going to come when baby's going to come kind of thing. So
we have no, it's the act of having a baby is the act of giving up all control.
Yes.
Like, it's wild.
Absolutely. Just like completely surrendering. And then I feel like there is a part of me that feels so grateful for infertility, because that was like the ultimate, like, Sammy, you surrender. Want control, but you have no fucking control. Like, good try. So that's been kind of cool. Cause I'm like, she's doing whatever the fuck she wants, and I'm just along for the ride. So we'll see.
I have a good friend who we should actually have on this podcast, but she is a therapist, and her baby's 6 weeks younger than Noah. And we have like a group chat with another friend who has a baby similar age. And she always says, like, I'm not in control. Cause I'm like, what time does so-and-so nap? Like, so we can plan blah, blah, blah. She goes, I don't know. I'm not in control. And I'm always like, I know, it's so hard, but like so amazing that she has that perspective. Cause I'm always like, well, my app says it's time to nap. Like,
well, yes. And I think structure, right? I mean, you know, babies and kids need structure, and I think there's a balance, but like you said, like before we even started recording today, you were like, just when I feel like I have everything smooth set, then it's like, oh, okay, we're changing. Like,
no, it changed his mind.
Yep.
Oh, it's crazy. It's in this, like, it's this act of, and I say this to people all the time, but like, I am a very inherently selfish person. And what Noah, as my teacher, has become is teaching me how to truly be less selfish. Like, it's important to have and make time for yourself and, you know, provide for yourself in certain ways. But like, my life, you just can't be the selfish person that you once were. And I'm talking to myself. And that's like, that's been the biggest lesson of 2021 for me and still learning.
Yeah. And that makes sense. I mean, because it's like, I feel like, I don't know if you got through Transformed by Birth yet.
Oh, it's right here.
Yeah. By Britta
Bushnell.
Can we get
her on the podcast?
Yeah, we should. Britta Bushnell. We love her. We both have it right next to our computers. But like talking about just that metamorphosis, right, of becoming a mother and how like, that part of you, like no one talks about that, how like that part of you dies and then you're like reborn and you're never, you have to grieve like that part of you or that person. Like, it's not like you're a whole different person, but they're in a way, yes. And
in the past, I wouldn't have ever said that, but like living it, like, I'm just not who I once was. And it's funny, and I don't want to go on a tangent, but you know, this past weekend, I was supposed to compete in this huge competition fitness competition that I haven't done anything fitness related since years, like since really I was disordered, and I've avoided it at all costs. And I had a conversation with somebody when they asked me why I wasn't participating in my gym competitions, like the ones at the gym that I go to. And I basically had to just kind of say to her, like, this is my boundary, and my entire worth used to be tied to my performance in these types of like gym events, and people expected things from me. And that was my business. It was like to perform. And I've really taken myself so far away from that and have healed my relationship with fitness so much so that like doing something like that just doesn't work for me anymore. But this was a relay, and it was with a group of people, and it was for fun. And I was so excited about it. And I got myself to a place where I was so excited about it. And then it was canceled. And I realized like in that moment that like the person that I once was before Noah was the person that like, that would have been absolutely destructive for me. Mm-hmm. And my entire worth and everything was connected to that space. But now it was like, okay, we'll just do it for fun. And then maybe I'll do it again, or maybe I won't. And I don't need to exercise for 15 hours that I don't have to prepare for something like this anymore. And it just showed this like tremendous in my head, like growth of who I've really become this year besides a mom, but how different my life and my priorities are. And it's just crazy. And I'm not really sure why I told that story now, but I feel like it matters.
It does matter. It's because like we were saying, like when you I don't know. I just feel like before people have kids, and again, I don't have kids, but when we were like younger, like you would see someone like with a baby, be like, oh, how's your baby? Like, oh, and you would never ask about the mom, right? Like you and I have talked about this many times on the podcast, but it's just like wild that like you have birthed a human out of your body and now they are a growing human with their own thoughts and emotions. And like, that is, first of all, like birth is trauma. Like we know that, like it's traumatic, but it is life changing. And like, we just go about it like, oh, like she had a baby. And it's like, no, like she had a baby. And like now every time, like I know someone that's had a baby, I'm like, tell me like your story. Like, I want to know, like, because you know that they are like so changed, like forever changed. So I
think everything about them and their relationships too. And like, just, oh, it's just so interesting. And I told you, like, I literally wrote cards to people because I was like, I had no idea. Like you, and I think our parents too, like I asked my mom, she was here yesterday with Noah, and I was like, do you really remember like feeling like I feel right now, which is like so happy and I'm loving this stage, but like I'm fucking exhausted. Like, right? And it's like, I love my husband, but like his job, his role with Noah is just different. Like the default is to the mom. That's just how it is, right? For some structures, and it is in our family. And like, if I have a 2-hour nap on a day that I'm not working, but I'm with Noah, like I'm cleaning, I'm putting things away, I'm working, I'm doing all of these things. And like the other day, and I love him and he does so much, but like the other day he was with Noah for most of the day and on Noah's nap, like he was napping. And I was like, like, no, get up, like, get up and go do something. And I said that to my mom and she was just like laughing. She's like, of course I remember that. And I was like, why didn't you warn me?
it's going to be a beautiful journey that I can't wait to contribute my exhaustion to. And it's crazy to think. So this is live on Friday, March 11th. We are headed into a, like Jenna had said, 10 weeks of reposting or re-releasing our, I don't want to say 10 favorite, because again, we truly like are so intentional about every single guest that we bring on What the Actual Fork podcast, but we're bringing back 10 episodes that are just fucking incredible and so different, right? Everything from body image to fitness to thin privilege to gender identity to can you lose weight with intuitive eating, our number one episode with Evelyn Triboli, the co-author of Intuitive Eating.
And that's because you and I send that every single day.
Literally to everybody. Like anybody that asks me, I'm like, here you go. Like, listen to Evelyn. Like, I don't want a deal. Like the one with the Protecting Your Peace one with The Nutrition Tea on Instagram. Mm. That one I feel like we were laughing like the whole time with that.
Block
one.
And be blessed.
Yes.
Remember? That was her line.
Yes. I use that every day. So these next 10 weeks will be amazing, because unless you are like our groupie and have listened to every single episode we put out, this
and we love you.
Yes. Then you can kind of get some of our highlights. And then that brings us right up until our release date. Yep. Which is Friday, June 3rd, right at that morning time that we have. So that'll bring us right to season 3, which we already name dropped Dr. Asher Larmy, which we're pumped.
What is baby's due date?
And baby's due date is 2 days before that.
How exciting.
She might be here. She might be like, nah, I'm going to just cook for like an extra 2 weeks and give you hell, but we have no idea.
You'll love it.
yeah. So like, no idea, but... But yes.
In between these 10 weeks, Sam and I will actually see each other in person. So we'll be able to at least say hi to you guys, maybe on the Instagram together, which will be so fun. Yes. I can't wait for that.
Yes. And I'm so excited. Jenna's coming to my baby shower in Florida, which is just crazy that that's even happening.
Part of your present last night. I'm so excited.
It's so weird. Like getting all of these baby things coming to my house. I'm like, I don't even have a baby, but like,
how
there's
do you feel?
Like,
can you share
yeah
like about the stuff coming in, about like physically obviously, but like emotionally, mentally, like there's so much going on.
Yeah, I feel like there's just so much nuance to pregnancy, like yeah. That like depending on the day you catch me, I'll answer this question completely different. I think for me, and I know every like again like how you would answer this question during pregnancy is gonna be different than me, different than every woman in the entire world. I think coming from infertility, I've heard people have different experiences. So I thought I had this expectation that I'd be super anxious, but like we said before, like, I think the main theme of my pregnancy has been, Sammy, you have no control, just fucking surrender, because like you, like she's growing, my body's doing what it needs to do. And like, there's literally nothing I can do. So that's been really cool. Cause I feel like it's been like a total yes. And then practicing that for motherhood, because I think there's like all this pressure on like pregnancy being hard and like labor being hard. And then like people, like you've been so open about your journey in the fourth trimester, and like people like Cam Rogers and Dylan Murphy, and just like connecting with all these people on Instagram that talk about this fourth trimester. I feel like I've been really practicing like mindset now. So then when that fourth trimester comes, it's like same thing, surrendering like fully. So that's been like really my focus, I would say.
That's beautiful.
But I mean, other than that, it's like, you know, the typical aches and pains, like the sleeping, and like, it hurts to sit too long. It hurts to stand too long. It hurts to walk too long. It also hurts to sleep. So it's like, and it's like, oh, I still have like, you know, 10 plus weeks to go. So that'll be interesting to see how that continues. But generally speaking, just grateful to even be at this place. And that's amazing. Like, that's like the overarching thing, but I don't want it to sound like it's all like rainbows and butterflies. Cause like, you know, there's days that you're like, I'm fucking exhausted. Or like, sometimes I feel like showing up on social media has been harder. Cause sometimes I'm just like, I just like don't want to talk. Like,
well, do you feel like you're getting out of breath? Because I just remember I was like so breathy, like the entire time, once my stomach started like really squishing my lungs.
Like, yes. I tried to call a doctor like while I was walking to like switch an appointment or something. And I guess I was like walking too fast. And I was like, they probably are like, what the fuck is this person doing? But, and then I have my glucose tolerance test on Monday. So
wait, it's honestly delicious. You're going to enjoy it.
I was the first person to say I did not hate it.
It tasted like a high C. Like, did you ever have those?
Did you have fruit punch? Did you have fruit punch?
I had orange and it was delicious. It literally tasted like a high C juice box. And all I kept thinking of was that character, that green character that was on the ones that was green, lime green. And I wished that I had that one. Like, I really didn't mind it.
What's funny, like people do freak out and I'm like, hey, have you ever had an acai bowl? Because you've had 100 grams of sugar in one sitting. Like, I've been training for this my entire pregnancy.
I'm going to be great. Yes. The hardest part for me was sitting in my car because of COVID, because they were like, you can't come in. Ooh. So like, you have to drink it and time it perfectly in your car. And at 29 minutes or whatever it is, like, you can come back in the building. And I was like so anxious that I was going to miss the time that I probably spiked my blood sugar from that, not from the sugar.
Yeah. Yeah. So it's interesting because people are like, yeah, freaking out about 100 grams of sugar. And I'm like, you've definitely had 100 grams of sugar in it one sitting and you just like have no idea. So I think that's just like kudos to being a dietitian and being able to be like, this isn't really that big of a deal. But it would suck to fail it, because I actually have a lot of friends who failed it, who had to go back for like the 3-hour one. And I'm like, dear Lord, like, I have done so many doctor's appointments, 39 fertility appointments alone in 2021, not counting 2022. So I'm like, can we just like not have that extra one? Like, let's just pass this. But so we'll see.
Fine.
TBD.
You and I also just like have to note, did you get curtain bangs yesterday?
I did.
Wait, you did?
Yeah, but they're long. Like that's what curtain bangs are, right? Like, so I can still pull them back.
Okay, that is not what I was picturing.
Yeah, so you, I knew when you commented on my TikTok that you didn't know what curtain bangs were.
I was like, if this was getting bangs, no, it's a bowl cut.
No, so curtain bangs are like you pull back the curtains, right? So it's like they're like that. That's what a curtain bang is. You have not been watching TikTok enough, Jenna.
I feel like that's a face frame. Is that?
It basically is, but like. People get them.
I was literally sitting here like, if this girl gets these, she is not going to be happy once this baby comes, because they say you cannot make drastic decisions about your physical features when you're pregnant because it's not you thinking.
Yeah, no, it had to be able to tuck behind the ear and get pulled back. So like, I was very aware of that. But yeah, no, like I've been growing my hair out specifically so I can twist it in a bun on the top of my head.
Yes.
For when the baby comes.
I now wash my hair twice a week. It's very ritualistic. It's Sundays and Thursdays. That's it.
I think I wash it once a week. Like I've never washed my hair like more than that. We should maybe do a podcast on hair washing. Because yeah, I hate washing my hair.
Hair washing just today is tomorrow, but it looks like a little bit of a push today for me.
But that's where you just really commit to like the tight pony or the tight bun, even throw some hairspray in there. And then it just looks like baller, like you just look like a badass, like who cares, you know what I mean? Like
people watch these on YouTube because my like baby bangs, if I like these, not everybody gets these, but like this.
Oh, I already like have that. Oh, I also was diagnosed with alopecia or whatever. There's like another word after it. That could be a whole nother thing. It's just another autoimmune. I have 5 autoimmune now. So we're thriving over here.
Okay. Great.
Let's bring in autoimmune. Wait, we do. Never mind. I'm not going to ruin
our guests for season 3.
No, we already have them scheduled. The one doctor. I don't want to say.
Oh, yes. Okay.
Because I want to talk to him all about all of my autoimmune and how it's all tied together.
That's going to be very exciting. Well, we promised this would only be 20 minutes and it has not been, but we also would love to know from you guys if you want to share on social media, like any questions or things that you would like Sam and I specifically to answer, if we can squeeze any in before baby P is here. We would love to do so to answer some of your questions. If not, we have so much coming for you guys, like just so many great interviews, anywhere from fitness to, like Sam said, autoimmune and disease state management with intuitive eating and more body image, maybe.
Yeah. I feel like we're always throwing more in there. So yeah, like Jenna said, shoot us a DM at What the Actual Fork Pod on Instagram and just enjoy these next 10 weeks of re-releases, because if you have not listened to them, they're absolutely fantastic. And then we will see you again on Friday, June 3rd, launching season 3. And yeah, so much exciting stuff. And next time we come back, hopefully our girl gang has grown, or our gang has grown, and Noah will have his little girlfriend.
I can't wait.
Alrighty, guys. We love
you. Bye, guys.
Thank you for listening. And we will see you next season.
Guys, thank you so much for listening to another episode of What the Actual Fork Pod. We know there are a lot of pods out there, and we are so grateful that you are here listening with us. If you enjoyed this episode, please be sure to subscribe, like, share with all your friends and faves, and follow along with us on social at What the Actual Fork Pod. We promise to continue to bring you the hottest topics, greatest guests, and the most fun you can possibly have while fighting diet culture bullshit. We love you, we appreciate you, and we will see you next week for a lot more fun.